What came first, the chicken or the egg? Spotlight on both.
Mate, right, what are you on about? Obviously, it was a chicken.
Now, you could say it was a dinosaur, because of like genetic mutations and stuff like that, but it's still a stupid question.
My mummy says you don't need to worry about silly questions like that, because worrying is going to get you nowhere.
Blackout. If Jesus could walk on water, can he swim on land? Spotlight on me.
Me, mate, what are you on about swimming on land? That's not possible, lad.
Jesus is a fictional character, and so is everyone else in the Bible, so you should get that stupid picture out of your mind.
I like swimming, but I don't like when people ask stupid questions.
Blackout.
Did humans really evolve from monkeys?
Spotlight on me.
Mate, why are you worrying about that? Really don't need to. Do you know what? Right. Come back mine with me. We'll have a bed and we'll just chill. You don't need to worry about it.
Look at this. The youth of today actually asking an alright question. Yes, they did, my friend.
Don't worry. Be happy. Blackout.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
Should homosexual relationships be allowed?
Come on, baby, I'm waiting for you.
I'm coming.
I don't have all night. Get over here. Oh my god, I want to take all of that off. Woo! I feel it in my bones!
So, am I picking James up from Frankie's, or are you picking James up?
I told you that she's not going to Frankie's tomorrow. I'm picking him at 2 o'clock, he's got a dentist appointment. Don't tell me, you forgot again!
No, I don't remember you telling me.
You said you were going to go with him, he's having free teeth out, he wants to start with him.
You know I am around, but anyway.
Oh, well, you know what, I'll tell you on, so don't go up for him. I'm going to sleep. Shattered.
Hey, do you remember that little Italian you used to go to when we first got together?
What?
You know the one on that Bold Street, up Bold Avenue?
What about him?
Well, I was wondering, like, if you've not got plans on Friday, if you'd like to go out.
Friday? Who's meant to look after James? My mum goes to the ballroom on Friday, yours does bingo.
Could pay for one.
No, don't be stupid, it costs about £30.
Aye, but it's one off, innit?
No, we've got to sleep in the morning. I'm asleep.
It is our anniversary.
Hey, Robert. Bill.
Chris.
Chris. You've been nervous.
Yeah.
How long have you been acting?
Only a couple of years.
Only a couple. I've been acting 13.
Must be experienced.
I'm not all of it.
Can candidate 2 and 6 and 2 and 9 and stage area, please? Now, can I just make sure that here we've got Philip?
That's me, yeah. Hi. Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Hi.
And Chris. Okay, we'd just like to take a look at scene 6, if that's all right. That's the Johnny confession scene.
Hey, Johnny. I just wanted to talk to you about a few things. Back 5 years ago at Cafe Zimbabwe when we first met, we were best friends from the get-go. I started developing feelings for you, and I want us to be more than friends. You see, I love you, Johnny.
Cut! Okay, thank you very much. We'll be in touch. It's either going to be another audition, a recall, or you've got the part. Okay, thank you.
Thanks. I told you we were going to kill it.
How's it going after last week's audition?
Good.
You sure you're alright, you don't seem...
Yeah, I'm fine.
Can candidate 2106 and 2109
enter
the stage area, please? Hi.
Hi.
Alright, just to be sure, here we've got Philip.
Yep.
And Chris.
Yeah.
We want to see the same scene again, that's scene 6.
No, we're Jenny, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hey, Jenny. Yeah. I have a lot of things on my mind to say.
Do you look less angry, Chris, please?
Max. I had a lot of things on my mind to say. Ever since we met back in Cafe Zimbabwe, we were best friends from the get-go. I've started developing feelings for you, you see. I want us...
Cool. Is there a problem, Chris?
No. It's just not my day.
Okay, so can you repeat the scene again?
I
don't think that's a good idea.
What, sorry, are you done? Do you not want it at all then?
I mean, it's not that I don't want the part, it's just that I can't do a gay scene with a gay actor.
Well, that's quite professional. So if you wouldn't like the part, can you just exit that way? Thank you. We'll be in touch.
So that's it?
Yeah.
I'll be in bed in a second. I love him, you know. My boyfriend, his positivity, his sense of humour, even his bum, I mean, he's got a great bone structure, but I just love the visuals when he walks away. But most of all, I love him because he loves me. He loves the real me. You see, I'm not what most people class as normal. See, I like boys, and people just don't understand that. Jack, he tells me that I just get unlucky, that I go to the wrong auditions. But the truth is, right now in this moment, that's when I can be myself. Because I'm alone. Nobody's judging me. Nobody. Because I'm alone. The silence, just without a shadow of a doubt. Because I'm alone. Now, this might be the most hippie thing I've said in my life, but you can't fight hate with hate. See, I've tried. I've been so negative throughout my whole life. But it just doesn't work. So what you gotta do is you gotta accept yourself. I've embraced myself. And right now I know that I'm a man. Not a gay man, not a straight man. That's just some label people want you to know. They probably want to put it on a t-shirt. I'm a man. And what matters to me is the notebook I write in every day. It's me, this house, and that man in the room right there who wakes up next to me each and every morning and makes me look forward to each and every night. That's what matters in life.
Of 18 to 24 year olds identify as something other than heterosexual.
Ha! Gay!
Thank you.
some sense. Okay, knew it, since one night it'd be a lad, and, you know, it'd be alright. And then the next night it'd be a girl, and it was confusing and weird, but it makes sense now. I'm bisexual, because I like boys, and I like girls. I'm bisexual.